and match, we have to choose the correct code. Sima Vishnu, he was a Rashtrakuta king. Jaisimha I, he was a Chalukyan king. Aditya I, he was a Chola king. Mamallapuram, it's an important dockyard that was there. So according to the option 2, 1, 4, 3, C becomes the answer for question number 1. Coming to question number 2. Which of the following was written by Harshcharita? Harshcharita was written by Vanavata and not by Harsh. Second, Priyadarshika. Yes, see, Priyadarshika, it was written by Harsh. Not only Priyadarshika, but also Harsh got Harsh wrote two other, Ratnavali, Priyadarshika, and Nagananda. These were the three books which were written by Harsh. Harshashtra, everyone knows it was written by Kautilya. And Vikrama Urvashim, it was written by Kalidas. So according to the option, B becomes the answer for question number 2. Coming to question number 3. Bagh, Hiranya, and Bali were three kind of taxes collected during the following king's administration. Friends, Bagh is basically a land tax that is paid in kind, and usually it is 1/6 of the total. Hiranya is basically a tax paid by the merchants and also by the farmers, but the tax is paid in cash, and Bali is another form. And therefore, for question number 3, B, these were the taxes which were imposed during the time of Harsha, and therefore B becomes the answer for question number 3. Coming to question number 4, the sculptures such as Nataraj and the Sadashiva can be seen at Ajanta, no, Ellora is also wrong, Badami Caves is also wrong, Elephanta Caves. Therefore, D becomes the answer that has been beautifully defected in the Elephanta Caves. For question number 4, D becomes the answer. Coming to question number 5, Gangaikond Cholapuram was built by which dynasty? A, Chola dynasty. The first is the answer itself. Basically, the Gangaikond Cholapuram was built by Rajendra I. It was basically built on the model of Brihadeshwara temple that has been built in Thanjavur. Gangaikond Cholapuram was basically built after Rajendra I. He invaded the northern part of the country. For example, he came towards Ganga, took the waters from Ganga, and then built a city in Gangaikond Cholapuram. So therefore, question number 5, A becomes the answer. Coming to question number 6, which of the following dynasty had trade relations outside India? Chela, Chola, Pandyas, and none of them. It is basically the Cholas dynasty which had trade relations with the neighboring countries, and to an extent that they had the influence even in the southeast part of the country, and even the trade relations had been established with the China and the nearby countries also. So question number 6, A becomes the answer. Coming to question number 7, consider the following statement with regard to Amar Falcon, and we have to choose which are correct. It is indigenous to the Nilgiris in India. The first statement is wrong, because this Amar Falcon, they are coming to India, for example, from Southeast Siberia region, or for example, for the Northern China. From this region, Siberia and China region, it flow towards, migrate to India, and from India, it migrate towards South Africa, and then take a round and then back go to Siberia and Northern China. Therefore, the first statement is wrong. Second, it is listed as least concerned on the IUCN list owing to its killing or for the meat. Yes, it is also listed as the least concerned. The second statement is right. For question number 6, B becomes the answer. Question number 8, consider the following statement regarding the Central Adoption and Resource Authority, that is CARA. The first statement is, and we have to choose which are incorrect ones. It is a constitutional body of the Ministry of Women, Child and Development, Government of India. The first statement is wrong, because CARA is not a constitutional body, as no constitutional provisions have been made for this. And what it is, a statutory body that has been created under the Ministry of Women and Child Development. The second statement, it deals with both in-country and inter-country adoption. Yes, the second option is right. In-country and inter-country adoptions are dealt by it. So according to the option, we have to choose the incorrect one. A becomes the answer. Coming to the 9th question for the day. Which of the following countries of Africa share coastline with Mediterranean Sea? The countries of Africa, Tunisia, yes, Algeria is also there, Morocco is also there, Libya is also there. So therefore, for question number 9, D becomes the answer, all the countries are there. Friends, moving from west to east, I would be telling you the countries of Africa from west to east, which they share the boundary with Egypt. A boundary with the Mediterranean Sea, and moving from, or you can move from east to west, is the same thing only. For example, when you move from east to west, the countries can be Egypt on the one hand, Libya, then Tunisia, then Algeria, and then Morocco. This is a series in which the countries of Africa, they have the coastline with the Mediterranean Sea. Coming to the last question for the day, question number 10. While approaching the Pacific Ocean from the side of Asian continent, Which geological features would you encounter the last? Which geological feature would be coming at the last? Continental shelf, it would be the first thing that would be coming, slope, then shelf, then slope, then Mariana Trench, it would be coming in between, and then East Pacific rise or mid-oceanic ridge. This is the last physical feature that would be coming while we are approaching the Pacific Sea from the side of Asian continent. For question number 10, D becomes the answer. Thank you very much, friends, for watching this video. I hope that this will be useful for your preparation while preparing for the exam. Best of luck.